Now let me tell you here, those people who have acidity and those who are on antacids and those who have constant problem with the stomach, trying it every 4 hourly in the initial few days. For about a week, 10 days time till your stomach settles down. Trust me, it will settle down. The stomach is used to producing a lot of acid for the enormous amount of food that you've been eating. Now when you start eating little by little, the stomach will slowly reduce the amount of acid that needs to be secreted. Over a period of time, you will be able to stop your antacids also. So in the initial stages, eat every 4 hourly, over a period of time, then slowly make it 6 hours, 8 hours, be comfortable. As you begin to get comfortable, you increase the gap. And then slowly stop your antacids over a period of time. Don't suddenly stop, taper it down slowly over a period of time. Now, the most interesting part in the night, what can you eat? Now, any diet in this world, anybody tells you the diet, they're going to tell you what you're supposed to eat, what you're not supposed to eat. But this diet has no restrictions on what you eat. No restrictions on sweets, no restrictions on non-vegetarian, no restrictions on fatty food, nothing. You can eat what you want. And my concept is very simple. You work hard, you spend a lot of time in the office, business, do whatever you want. What is it for? Basically, you're earning money to eat a good food, a good meal. What's the point in denying yourself a good meal with all the hard work that you've done for all these years? You must be able to eat tasty and good food. Now, the concept is very simple. You eat what you want, but you eat only the bowlful. That's all my rule. You can eat what you want. You can eat sweets. Trust me, a lot of people who are diabetic, blood pressure, thyroid, have gone on this diet and they've been able to reduce their medications over a period of time. Now, what makes sense to eat this bowlful? Let me ask you this. When you go to a wedding, you serve yourself one plate of biryani. The biryani might have a lot of rice, chicken, mutton, or vegetarian, or whatever it is. Then you start eating. The first bite, very tasty. Second bite, very tasty. Third bite, it's very tasty. You even find out who made this food. From the fourth bite onwards, you start talking to people, and then you start eating. Then you realize that your plate is empty. Till then, you do not know what you're doing. Then you go and fill your plate again with the same thing. Then again you eat. Then you keep talking to people. And when it fills your stomach, you start getting a little discomfort in the stomach. That's when you realize, okay, I should stop. A bowl of ice cream. First bite, very tasty. Second bite, tasty. Third bite, tasty. Then you only realize when it is about to get over, you want to lick the ice cream. Sounds familiar? This is called as unconscious eating. This is what all of us do. Not because we enjoy the food, not because we need the food. We've been told to eat so much till your stomach is full. So we go on unconsciously eating and filling our stomach. This is what we do. Instead, now you take the biryani, you take mutton, chicken, vegetable, whatever it is, and take this much. Put it on the plate. Spread it out. Start eating. Don't you agree that you will consciously eat every bite of the food that is there in the plate? Won't you consciously enjoy every bite of the food? The food that we eat has to be tasty. I'll tell you why. The moment you smell food, you have salivation. The moment you start eating the tasty food, your mouth salivates. Saliva is one of the most important part of digestion of the food. The more saliva, the more the digestion. Most of the digestion happens in the mouth. Now, when you eat consciously, your saliva is overflowing and your digestion happens. Now, instead, if you are eating a diet food like one of those diet restricted food which you don't like, will you salivate? You won't. It's not a tasty food. Now, if it's not tasty and if you don't salivate, how the hell will the food digest? So this makes a lot of sense. Every time you have a meal, take it into this, spread it out, and consciously eat every bite of food that you're eating. That makes a lot of sense. Have you ever eaten your food with your eyes closed? You must try it out. You take a little rice, add some rasam, add some sambar, add some a little bit of chicken piece, and then take one helping, put it in your mouth, close your eyes, and start to chew. When you begin to chew, you appreciate a lot of things about the food, the texture of the food, the different tastes that pour out every time you chew. There are different flavors that come, the different taste. It's an experience. You should experience it. That is what eating is all about. Experience each and every taste that comes out of each and every bite. Be conscious. Try it out one time. Then you will know what I'm talking about. So every bite that you take needs to be eaten consciously. Now, once you start on this diet, there are three things that happens. Number one, it'll start improving your health. I already told you start feeling better in your energy. Your health will start to improve. Then your inches will start to disappear. And for those people who got BP, diabetes, keep checking it, because there may be a drop in it, and then adjust your medicines accordingly. Thyroid patients, once in 3 months, keep checking your thyroid levels also, and you can adjust your medicines accordingly. Now, one of the main questions people ask is, does one feel tired while you're on this diet? I've already told you, we are left with a lot of energy for the rest of the body, so there is no chance of feeling tired. But let me ask you this question. Have you seen how much this laborer or these guys who work on the farm work? Do we even do 5% of physical activity they do? We don't. There is no chance of us feeling tired unless you are doing a marathon or you are doing some physical labor. Otherwise, you do not feel tired. Not possible. Now, my question is, when you are able to eat such lovely food, why deny your body of such fantastic food that is available to us? The only catch here is the bowl. Now, people who have been on this diet below 40 have been able to lose about 3 to 5 kgs a month. Above 40, 2 to 3 kgs. And we have had tremendous results from people who have been using this diet. Try it out. I'm not restricting you from eating anything. I'm not stopping you from eating anything. I'm telling you to eat everything. This is the only thing. I'm only asking you to de-addict from your food addiction. Not the food, the quantity of food. Try it out. It's worth it. Take care. Stay healthy.